Sorry, I'm busy at the moment.
Sorry, so am I. Okay, CeltCorp. Like Celtic or something. Oh, look at this place. Fantish Mansion looks like a little smattering of Ireland.
Something I can do for you, love?
Clover. Cool name.
Again. Look, you can tell Mr. Okadibo that I'm doing everything I can.
Mr. Who?
Blood from a stone, if you'll pardon the expression.
You have me confused with someone else.
Oh. I'm afraid I've stepped right into it again. Damn. You aren't here about Mr. Okadibo's debt to CeltCorp. Oh, this is so embarrassing. Let me start over. My name's Clover McKenna, but you can call me Chloe. Sorry for me outburst.
Sorry for me outburst. Maybe I should have been wearing a name tag?
Yeah, maybe you should have, for my sake. This mess with Mr. Okadibo over at the Neon Mining League has really thrown me off my game.
Oh, that's what you're talking about. I know what it is. I've been there. I just want to hear what she says. What's the Neon Mining League?
It's a shop over in Okuchi Market. You know, the plaza next to Ryujin Tower? They sell all sorts of mining supplies and raw materials. It's a fine little shop, well-stocked and immaculate. Mr. Okadibo is the owner. He's a lovely, lovely man. But his aspirations are one grav jump longer than his business instincts.
Well, you don't strike me as the sort of person who's easily rattled.
Normally, yes. But in this case, Mr. Okadibo has put me in a real bind. Mr. Okadibo owes a substantial debt to CeltCorp. I've given him more than enough time to try and come up with the money. But my father's patience is running out.
Your father's
Frankly,
patience.
I don't know how much longer I can stall.
Your father's patience. Would you mind telling me more about your father?
Niall. Oh, he's the CEO of CeltCorp.
Niall?
The whole blessed thing. If you asked him, he'd claim he started the company with next to nothing and built it into a megacorp in under 30 years. Truth is, he tends to forget the multi-million credit trust he tapped into as a crutch. But that's my father for you.
So, hell of a crutch, really. More of like giving you wings to fly. Why should I call you Chloe, though?
Because my father has a ridiculous sense of humor, and I can't stand the name Clover. I mean, seriously, Clover?
I like it.
Our family's Irish, for God's sake. Don't think he could have possibly been more on the nose with that name. Ha ha, very funny, Dad.
If you are red, you could call yourself Crimson and Clover. Mind telling me a bit about CeltCorp?
We're a tech company that primarily specializes in mining operations.
On the mining side.
We handle everything from individual standalone units to fully engineered outpost systems. Basically, if it's made of rock, our gear chews it. Might not be as glamorous as some of the other corps in this building, but it pays the bills.
Okay. Are you in charge of the CeltCorp office here?
For now, but let's not mistake my position for what it really is. A test set up by my father. He's set to retire in a few years, and I'm his only next of kin. But I'm guessing he's not sure if I'm ready to take over the company. So he shuttles me out here for two reasons. One, to flash a friendly face for our clients he flies out here as a perk. And two, gets his firebrand of a daughter as far away from him as possible. He's a real piece of work.
Huh. These people are having problems with their fathers here. Like the other one I had to kill earlier. Maybe I could assist you in recovering Mr. Okadibo's debt?
You'd be willing to help out. That's awfully kind of you.
Yeah, I went over there again. It's kind of you to stick up for him in the first place.
Just because I work for a megacorp doesn't mean I don't have a heart. Saburo, Mr. Okadigbo, he's one of the nicest people you'll ever meet, especially in this city.
Hmm.
He really needs help, but he's too proud to accept any money from me. Maybe he'd listen to someone like you?
I don't want to be giving him all this money. Are you personally involved with Saburo? Sorry, I don't like trying to pronounce that last name.
That is a rather personal question, and I would prefer we kept things professional, if you don't mind.
Really? Okay. Yeah, I'll talk to him.
Oh, that'd be splendid. Just amazing. If you can get his debt off my conscience, I'd be grateful. It's been on my mind so much I've been keeping a diary. And don't worry about payment. I guarantee you won't be disappointed. McKenna always keeps that promise.
I want to read the diary. How did Saburo rack up so much debt?
When he opened the shop, he outfitted it with equipment from our company. Spent a bundle of cash he didn't have. Obviously, business hasn't been going well, because he's fallen way behind on his payments.
Hmm.
Opening a mining business on a world almost entirely covered in ocean probably wasn't the most savvy of business plans.
Yeah.
I suppose he intended to cater to travelers that were passing through our system. But it's clearly backfired. That poor man.
Well, it definitely wasn't a good idea of him.
Tough city. You watch yourself out there.
Thanks. Hard luck. Clover McKenna has asked that I help one of her clients, Saburo, get out of debt. She is willing to pay off his remaining balance, provided he gives her permission. Oh, she'll pay off the balance. That's good to know. And then find her diary.
I'm glad I ended up at CeltCorp. Ms. McKenna treats her employees like family.
Oh, good to know. Hi.
Save it for someone who gives a damn.
Okay, I think I like talking to her a little bit more. And gold pyramid sculpture.
What do you want to do for the break later?
I don't know, but I gotta get out of here. It's been non-stop interruptions since this morning, and I'm not spending another break at my desk listening to Cody eat with his mouth open.
Cody?
One of those days, huh?
More like one of those months. You know what? Screw it. I'm going to tear
No funny
right
stuff with that
now.
Boost pack. Got enough flight traffic as it is.
I'll go with you. We can pick up an extra for Chloe if she asks. Yes? What?
This. It doesn't look like I need to hack this, so I should be able to look at it. Shipping order status. Oops. Oh, crap. What happened there? Okay. Ship. Oh, what the hell? I'm getting interrupted by Microsoft notifications. I don't know if you saw that. Shipping order status. Shipping orders in progress. Consolidated mining. Status in transit. Consolidated mining pending approval. Six Sisters mining processing. Fascinating.
If you'll excuse me, I have a deadline to meet.
Are you supposed to be here?
Absolutely. Are you supposed to be here?
What? I'm working here?
No, you're just sitting there looking at space. There's a safe behind you. Can you open that and give me the stuff in there? No? Why not?
Unless this is about mass purchasing some mining equipment, I'm far too busy to stop and chat.
It's mass producing. Alright, that's it. That's it. That's this place. So at least these offices are a little smaller than the one on the other end. Ryujin Industries, that's what I was trying to remember. Stroud-Eklund Corporate HcQ.
Stroud-Eklund makes some of the finest ships in the settled systems. I'd love to get a look at their operations.
Okay. Well, it seems we're about to. Oh, is this the guy? Wait.
Our office is open. Just strive to keep interruptions to a minimum.
This is a different guy.
I'm in the middle of some quarterly earnings analysis. Excuse me.
You're excused.
I'm afraid I'm always in the middle of preparing for the next board meeting. If you'll excuse me, feel free to look around. Stroud-Eklund is the peak of ship manufacturing design.
Hey, I know your husband.
Well, I should hope so. He and I are very famous.
We go way back. What do you make exactly? Starships, I know. Spaceships?
Originally, both the Stroud and the Eklund corporations made consumer goods. Anything and everything a person could want. But after my husband and I married and merged the companies, we decided to make our mark on interstellar travel. And now the brand is nearly synonymous with starships. I still get questions from reporters wanting to know just how we pulled that transition off. And my answer is always the same. Money solves everything.
I see. What's your take on Neon's problems?
Oh, interesting question. Neon is the ultimate playground for people who have money. And that means we exhaust ourselves sabotaging each other. It's fun, but a huge waste.
You exhaust yourself.
Stroud-Eklund as a company doesn't believe in restraint. But sometimes, I wonder if Neon's lack of a moral authority isn't hurting everyone. Even us.
All right, thanks. Funny thing is, this looks like the same room as the other Stroud-Eklund. I wanted to close the shutters. I cannot.
Don't make my job any harder.
Don't make my heart any jobber.
It's an honor to be a part of the Stroud-Eklund team.
Okay. I commend you on your efforts.
What? I'm working here.
I commend him on his efforts. And I was not talking to you.
If you'll excuse me, I have a deadline to meet.
If I'll excuse you, yes. Can I hack it from behind her? No. I don't want to steal anything. This is incredibly unrealistic. Just pretend she's drunk or something and she doesn't know what I'm doing. Oh, I've dead-ended myself. This one first. Announcements. Oh, it's all the same stuff. Quarterly update.
Make sure you check every entry. There might be some embedded data we could use to our advantage.
Your mouth wasn't.
Are you supposed to be here?
No, I wasn't supposed to hack your computer either. And her mouth was not moving.
Stay out of trouble, or we'll have a problem.
I'm hacking stuff.
I could talk spacecraft modules all day, but I have a mountain of reports to complete.
Paramore and Nervajack? Oh. You're over there now. I'm not sure what that is. I guess drugs. Oops. Oops. Oh, it's only showing this one. An enhancement to the chem synapse alpha. Oh, known to improve cognition. Research problems require fewer resources for 10 minutes and plus 50% of research sudden developments. I forget what else I picked up. Was it boosted injector? I'm not sure. Something I'm not familiar with. Oh, Neurojack. An enhancement. Oh, yeah, it's another. Was that the one I just looked at? Wait a second. Neurojack? Yeah, it is. Never mind. Yeah, I'm not completely sure what else I picked up, but I might use it at some point. Alright, done here. Moving right along. Oh, I have to find her diary. Wait a second.
Can't talk. I've got a deadline coming up.
Sorry, oh. I'm busy at the moment.
That's her diary? Clover McKenna's diary. I have to admit, this business with Saburo is keeping me up at night. I can see how it's starting to wear on him, personally and professionally. Saburo is a good and honorable man. Pride won't allow him to accept my money, but what he doesn't understand is the game is rigged. Even in good times, variable interest rates are designed to landslide you. You got that right. All I want is to give him a fair shake. I may not believe in every idea he has, but I believe in him. He just needs a financial partner who can offer some direction. Someone who has his best interests at heart. I won't lie, given my position, it may be a conflict, but my feelings for him aside, I really do want to help. Cool. All right.
Cause any trouble and I'll drag you straight to lockup.
I'll shoot you. In the head. Alright. Now, two more, because we can't go there. And so we're going to Xenofresh Corporate Headquarters. Delicious, nutritious. Yeah, very colorful. A lamp planner? Oh, wow. So it's like a potted plants with a light.
Quit staring.
People are crazy. I'm staring at you. I've made her visibly uncomfortable.
Welcome to Xenofresh. How can I help you today?
Hello, Amanda Oxendine.
Welcome to Xenofresh, the pride of Neon.
What's it like working here?
Xenofresh is the best place to work in Neon, hands down.
Have you worked everywhere?
The pay is good, the hours are respectable, and the company's profits are skyrocketing. We're fortunate that Administrator Bayou dedicates his time and brilliance to see our company excel.
Wonder when I get to meet that guy. Is it true that Xenofresh manufactures Aurora?
The Free Star Collective has given Xenofresh Fisheries the sole right to fish chasm bass and use it to produce Aurora.
You could say yes.
If you care to sample some yourself, we have it for sale at the famous Astral Lounge. Although Aurora is our flagship product, we also produce a line of delicious seafood products as well.
Hmm. Seafood must be booming around here, actually.
Oh, try not to disturb Miss Grath. She's a busy woman.
I'll go talk to Miss Grath. Okay, will do. Oh, job application computer. I can apply here too. Let me see. There are currently no job openings. Please check back later. Why work at Xenofresh? Xenofresh Fisheries is the oldest and one of the most profitable corporations on Neon. That's why. The Xenofresh team is committed to excellence. We pay competitively and have career paths to suit every employee. So join us and join the future. I can't because there are no job openings. Quit staring.
Working at Xenofresh is amazing. I mean, come on. Free, Aurora?
Free?
What other corp can beat a perk like that?
Really? Free? That's some discount.
Working at Xenofresh is amazing. I mean, come on. Free Aurora?
That's the line?
What other corp can beat a perk like that?
Announcements. Oh. I guess it's from the building itself, because all these different corporations, they have the same exact notices.
You'll excuse me, I have a deadline to meet.
I will excuse you. I said I excused you. That means go away.
If you're looking for Aurora, you're in the wrong place. Try the Astral Lounge.
I'm looking for trouble.
I'm working here.
Trouble. Trouble. That's what I want. Yeah. Alright. I gotta go bother some executive lady. Wait. What opened? Was that the computer closing?
What is it?
Hi.
You're not a plate of croissants.
No, not lately. A plate of... Very perceptive of you to notice.
Then you're not... Oh, for God's sake.
I'm not croissants.
That foolish girl up front must have allowed you back here. I'm going to have a bit of a chat with her later. I'm really quite busy. If you're not here on Xenofresh business, I'm going to have to ask that you leave.
Who are you?
My name's Libby Groth, and I am the CFO of Xenofresh Fisheries.
What's a CFO?
And since I answer directly to Administrator Bayou, I hope you aren't here to cause any sort of trouble. The last thing I need right now are more protests and complaints to deal with.
Well, I've come from Administrator Bayou's office, and he tells me that you are to be beheaded immediately. What sort of protest do you have to deal with?
Everything under the sun, from unfair business practices to reported bad working conditions to the price of Aurora. We're the number one most successful corporation on Neon, so we're obviously a huge target of opportunity for slander and false accusations.
Oh, poor you.
Everyone's looking for a free handout or a tiny piece of the massive success that we've accomplished.
Push on.
I'll tell you the same thing I tell them before I have them escorted out. It's not going to happen. Not on my watch.
What won't happen? Protests?
Are we done here?
I guess. Do we have to be done here? Well, maybe it was Paramore. Was that the other thing I found? Paramore? Who's that lady? Let's just look under... I can't. It's too small. There we go. Paramore. Oh, I have... Yeah, that's the upgrade to Hippolyta. That might have been the thing I found in the other office, maybe.
Is this really necessary?
Yep.
I have to be somewhere important.
I'm inspecting the office. Please just go about your business as normal. Priceless gem? Why is it called priceless gem in quotes, and it's value 12? Are you trying to pass it off as a priceless gem?
Sorry, I'm busy at the moment.
Not interested.
Neither am I. Okay. Slayton Aerospace, final one. This is how long it takes to explore Neon. Got some books. Oh. One's a book and the others are just... Well, the others, it's a notebook. Very interesting. Hmm.
You have a question? You can chat with the receptionist all you want.
Level 14 you are, huh? I'm looking for a ship called the Millennium Falcon. I heard it beat the Kessel Run in 12 parsecs. Can't look at the computer. Riley?
Welcome to Slayton Aerospace. I'm afraid we aren't taking appointments right now.
Okay. Very nice. Activate the alarm. Is there a reason we should be doing that? Maybe look around first.
Hoping to get a meeting? I've been waiting all day. It's ridiculous.
If we pull the alarm, you might be able to. If I pull the alarm, these people attack?
I hear Slayton's had some major layoffs recently. Never a good sign.
Level 8?
Slayton sure takes his security seriously. I don't know whether to feel safe or nervous.
Oh, that's all you had to say? I was gonna sit down and listen to you for a little... Never mind.
Your company send you out here too? I don't see the point of face-to-face meetings with component vendors, to be honest.
I don't have a company. Ah, security.
Welcome to Slayton Aerospace.
Why, thank you. How you doing?
Leave before I make you.
Oh, okay. He pulls out his gun. Jeez. You run out of there, yeah. Just leave them to their own devices. Expert lock. Authorized personnel. Are these accessible?
There a problem?
Nope. Novice lock. There's a switch. You wanted to leave, huh? Well, guess you're not doing that now. That's an expert lock, and that's a novice lock. Oops. Maybe let them leave. And then once he walks out here, then I can close the gate, right? I thought I closed this door. Trauma pack? I'm detected.
Glad I'm not the only one waiting around in this lobby.
I am fully detected. Oh. Heads up. Latrine inspector. Mm-hmm. I inspected them. They're definitely latrines. Mm-hmm. Very latrine-like. All in order. I want to pull the alarm, really. Oh, this door's open now. Elevator maintenance control. It's an advanced lock. Well,
not paid to talk.
Then why'd you say that? See, I hesitate for this because I know we can unlock it without being detected, but walking in could be another story. Completely.
I haven't seen a lock picked that easily since I traveled with Vladimir Sol.
Oh, look at all this. If there's anyone up here. Expert lock. Storage crate. Slayton utility key. Deep secret pack, molecular sieve, and a bat ball cap. I don't want the cap. There's another vent. This is where we came in. Alright, so there's an elevator control over there. Cyberrunner's Cipher 01 adds a bankable auto attempt for hacking. Huh, cool. Now, if I do this, only authorized personnel can use this. I have a key though. I know it can't be used for that, I'm sure. Slayton utility key. This is open now. They get mad if we go back here? Elevator maintenance. Oh, okay. Yeah, we're gonna have to do something in here, I know it. With the elevators and the alarm and all that fun stuff.
Yeah.
It's just they really don't care if we go back here. See, I'm just wondering if the key could get us past something, like in here. Ah, yeah. Where am I now? The light of stars. Yeah, I read that. Oops. Are we up on another level? cool.
This is a private office?
Hi.
Hey, you're not supposed to be here.
Says who? I'm on a personal tour.
Just leave, okay?
This is a private office.
Hey, you're not supposed to be here.
Just leave, okay?
I will. Just not right now. Cubic food.
You have a question? You can chat with the receptionist all you want.
Okay. Well, this is interesting.
You okay? That was a hell of a jump.
Yeah, I did. I'm out of practice. Alright, we're gonna have to do something with all that at some point. But for now, back down. Duty, I'm Scram. Okay. I don't like the sound of you. Alright, so I guess we're going to check out one of the other districts here. I guess whichever one we come across first. It's taken hours, literally hours, just to explore all the ones in this opening area. Well, technically the opening area is the security, you know, but, the cargo, spaceport is what I'm thinking of. But then we came here and it was huge. And I had a lot of stutters and the stutters stopped. Knock on wood, they don't come back. No stutters that I detected for over 3 hours. So anyway, I want to thank you guys for watching and hope to see you in the next episode. And always, seek adventure.